What's going on, everybody? It's a semi-beautiful day here in lovely Greenville, Tennessee, about an hour northeast of Knoxville, home of God's team. Speaking of God, this is a very special weekend. Every year, a lot of folks celebrate Easter.
I'm gonna go real talk on people today. My papaw, that's grandfather to you northern people, passed away back in 1988. Great man. Worked hard all his life. Every penny that man ever had in his pocket was a penny he worked hard for out in the fields. I respected that man up till the day he died, and I respect him now, 23 years later. So because I respected my papaw so much, and because I was taught as a young little sprouting BVD to respect my elders, that's why I respect you, Tin Man Boo, because you're like a papaw to me. You are the papaw of the TTC. Nobody else in the TTC can boast the things that you can boast. Retirement home, Social Security, AARP, AAA, and the senior citizen discount at Hardee's. I'm jealous. I can't help it. I'm not far away. I know I'm not far away from that senior citizen cup of coffee every morning. But you, Tin Man Boo, are all over it. And I respect you for that because I respect my elders. Today, folks, we're going to step back from Tennessee football just a little bit. And we're going to speak for just a moment on faith and religion. Faith and religion are topics that I generally tend to avoid. Two reasons. One, they're very controversial. And two, I still, at my age now, have not been able to ground myself in a firm belief. I still struggle with religion and faith. I have faith that there is something after this world. There's got to be. You can't tell me that we're put on this earth for the short period of time that we are, and then there's nothing afterward. To me, that makes no sense. There has to be a rhyme and reason to all of this. Is it God? Is it Jesus? Is it heaven above? I don't know. And the truth of the matter is, no one does until they move on from this earth. And at that point, there's no way to let the rest of us on earth know. That's where faith comes in. Those with a deep-seated faith, a deep-seated love for Jesus Christ, our supposed Savior. And I say supposed only because there is yet to be physical proof. Now, I know that comment's probably going to get me in trouble with some people. It might even have some people change their opinions of me. That's fine. That's why I don't talk about this all the time. That's why I don't talk about this subject hardly ever at all, because to me, faith and religion is a personal thing. It's something that each and every person on this earth should deal with at a personal level. That's between you and God, we'll say. The way I want to feel, the way I want to believe that there is a God and a heaven above us. I want to believe that when I move on from here, that I've done all the right things to get me into that heaven, into that mansion in the sky. That's what I want to believe. I don't want to believe, like my mother, that when you die on earth, that's it. I want to know that there's something else beyond here. And for me, just for me, a book that thick and the teachings and the preachings of others on this earth now, to me, is just not enough proof. Maybe that's going to cost me in the end. Maybe I die today. Maybe I die before I get this video uploaded. And there is a God and a heaven and a hell. And maybe because I don't have that 100% faith, and maybe because I'm not convinced, I may end up in hell. And if that be the case, I've made my bed. I cannot complain about it. But the simple fact of the matter is, folks, I cannot make myself believe something that I just don't believe in my heart yet. It's not a light switch that you turn off and on. I see a lot of people trying to do it. I see a lot of people out here in church on Sundays in their nice suit and tie with their wife in their beautiful dress and their cute little kids all gussied up, sitting in the front row of the church, amening and praise Jesusing. And then later that night, the man's out in a bar, or the man's over at his buddy's house playing poker, smoking a cigar, drinking back beer, cussing up a storm. You see a lot of that. That's not going to be me. I've tried going to church. I've given it everything I've got at believing. I've tried having faith. But I'm here to tell you from my own personal experience, until you truly get that in your heart, it don't work. It don't count. And for me personally, Big Vol Daddy, Keith, right here on Earth today, it honestly kind of worries me. I'm not going to lie to you. I am not going to lie to you, folks. Like I said, I wish I had that faith in my heart. I don't know what it is. I grew up in church. Up until I was 7, 8 years old, my dad and mom dragged me off to church almost every weekend. In my first marriage, my ex-wife dragged me to church. And for a time there, I was a believer. I was a 100% faith-based believer. Got saved, got baptized, the whole nine. I was in church every Sunday, every Wednesday. But for some reason, something along the way, and for the life of me, I don't know what it is, there's that something in me that keeps me from maintaining that faith, that belief. Some will tell me, BVD, that's the devil in you. Maybe it is. I don't know. I do not know. That is my problem. That is BVD's problem with faith and religion, is the fact that I do not know. I'm the kind of guy where I've got to see something on the table that proves to me absolutely this is the way it is. It's just the way it is. I'm not preaching to you guys today, obviously. I'm just saying. I'm just giving you my personal experience with faith. I hope and pray, ironically enough, that the rest of you out there have it figured out. I hope everyone's got it figured out in their mind. But for me, on my own personal walk with Christ, I have my issues. And for some people, that's a problem. But the thing is, that's their problem. It's not my problem. So what I will say to you folks today that are firmly entrenched in your faith, and are 1,000% convinced that there is a Jesus Christ, a God, and a heaven, I commend you. I'm happy for you. Your plan is laid out for you. And for the other folks out there, like me, that just don't know, that just aren't sure, I feel for you, because sometimes, folks, it can be an awful struggle. It can affect your life, because whether you want to admit it or not, in the end, that's important. And there's a lot of people out there, and I've met a bunch of them, that have no interest whatsoever in this right here. Don't even want to talk about it, not going to talk about it. In their opinion, there ain't no God, there ain't no heaven, there ain't no hell. Forgive my southern English. But that's the period, bottom line, cut and dry deal for them. I got questions. West Virginia Dirty Dog, There's a man right there firmly ingrained in his faith and belief. But I promise you, that man also has his moments and his days. You know he does. He's human. In our walk with Christ, if it was an easy walk, if it was a smooth, laid-out walk, there would be no problems in our daily lives. It'd all be cupcakes and ice cream, which is something I happen to really like. One Way Rock, our resident Mississippi State fan. There's another man that has a tenacious grip on his faith. There's a man that has several beliefs that he is 100% sure of, and he will fight you tooth and nail over them. That's the kind of inner strength that I want. That's the kind of faith that I am seeking but cannot find. Will it come in time? I don't know. Does it matter if it comes in time? I don't know. That's the big problem for me, is I don't know. But what I do know, what I am sure of, what I can 100% without any fault whatsoever assure you of today, Friday, before Easter 2011, I can tell you this. I hope each and every one of you has a great weekend. Those of you going to Sunday sunrise service, enjoy your time. Enjoy your relationship and your walk with God. Enjoy your family. And I hope everyone has a great weekend. And just for a moment, for just one moment this weekend, can we lay down the drama in the TTC? Monday, it's on, baby. It's on like Donkey Kong. Hoss, I got something for you. Yeah, probably not. Just sounded good at the moment. See, here's the thing. There's going to be a faction of people that if they see this video, the first thing that's going to pop into their head is they're going to be like, oh my God, that boy's going to hell. That boy is bound for hell. Then there's going to be a faction of people that watch this video that are going to be thinking, wow, I relate to that. I get that dude. I feel exactly like he does. Then there's going to be some people that see this video that say, this guy's a nut job. There's no heaven. There's no hell. Why is he even worried about it? Then there's going to be the really, really, really hardcore person that's going to wish they could get to me and save me and lead me to Jesus and show me the error of my ways and embed that faith and that feeling into my heart. I say to all of those different people, make your walk, I'll make my walk, my walk. And lest you think I had forgotten, with all this talk of faith and religion, one feeling, one love, one constant in my heart remains. And that's Go Big Orange, baby.